Welcome everyone. Welcome to our webinar in occasion of the ISUOG Congress. I would like to thank you very much for joining one of these three educational activities that we are having during this ISUOG Virtual Congress this year. I would like to thank you very much. I introduce myself. My name is Luca Mastrogirolamo. I'm International Clinical Support Manager. And I'm very pleased today to facilitate this event. And I'm very, very glad to have today Dr. Marc Althuser with us. He is the speaker of this webinar for today. He is a gynecologist working in Grenoble in France in fetal medicine. He's working in the hospital in Grenoble and also has his private practice. We are very happy today to have him. He will speak about one topic. The title of the lecture is the following: is the use of the novel technologies for low velocity blood flow, DFI, in fetal ultrasound scanning. Before his presentation, the lecture will have a short introduction made by Frédéric Philippe, that is the product manager for France. So, first of all, I give the control to Fred that will make this introduction, and then again to Dr. Marc Althuser.
Good morning, everybody. I will introduce you DFI. DFI is a micro color flow imaging that both provide high sensitivity and high resolution with high frame rate to depict vascular details and obtain easily an accurate diagnosis. Let's see why DFI is more sensitive. In this first graph, you can see the representation of conventional flow, color flow, power flow, and e-flow in relation to resolution. The problem in ultrasound is the interaction between the ultrasound beam and the tissue of the human body, which can sometimes cause artifacts. Even with the color modes, you can have artifacts caused by the movement of structures, such as the earth or vascular walls or by breathing movements. The DFI algorithm also works on the part of the signal containing motion artifacts. In the second graph, the flow velocity is compared to the intensity of the signal. In daily use, artifacts are cut by filters, but these filters also cut very slow flow, which is a useful signal to understand if a structure is vascularized or not. But DFI runs a specific algorithm which is able to cut motion artifacts while maintaining the representation of very slow flow. Now, if we compare DFI versus conventional color mode, DFI will detect characteristic of motion artifact on micro blood vessels in whole pixel of the color ROI, not each pixel. It is based on the intensity of whole pixels movement. It analyzes the entire ROI and uses the difference in the characteristic between motion artifacts and blood flow to distinguish them. Conventional flow detects blood flow, but using an autocorrelation processing calculated for each pixel. It is based on the phase changes of the receiving signal, and motion artifacts are removed by using a wall filter that removes both motion artifacts and slow blood flow. DFI does not use the change in phase of receiving signal, so it is not angle dependent and no steering is necessary, whereas conventional flow have to face to angle limitation. And finally, DFI detects motion artifacts and micro blood flow using a proprietary DFI scanning method with very high frame rate. And high frame rate helps to detect motion artifacts due to their cyclic nature and can reduce the contamination of useful slow blood signal. That's all for my part. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Fred. We can pass the control to Dr. Marc Althuser, that I would like to thank very much for his availability. Please, Marc, the stage is yours.
Thank you. Thanks, Luca. Good morning, everybody. The aim of my presentation is to show from a few examples the performances of a new imaging technology you heard about for visualization the low velocity blood below the previous detection threshold. As a preamble, I have to apologize for my quite poor English. With conventional Doppler, we have here a pulmonary vascularization, and is in this situation, it's very, very difficult to see the small vessels, and we only see the main trunks, but not the small trunks. With DFI, as you can see here, we have much more information. You can see the blood supplied is detected very far from the hile, and we go nearly the pleura. And if we increase the gain, as you see here, we have much more information and the mapping appear denser. Also, in the third trimester, depending on the setting, we can highlight the larger trunk or the small distal vessels, even the fetus is making breathing movement, like you can see on the right. In this situation where there is a pulmonary malformation associating cyst and hyperechoic parenchyma, the DFI system show a poor vascularization in the abnormal territory, as you can see here. So this is compatible with the CPAM. The brain vascularization is also a good example to show the contribution of DFI. We can easily reveal the entire pericallosal artery and its branches, like you can see here. And we have very often this picture because it's not very difficult to catch this kind of picture. Here at 22 years, we can see very easily anterior cerebral artery and its branches, frontal branches. We can also see pericallosal artery and the inferior sagittal sinus. And you can see just under the skull, the superior sagittal sinus, in which the flow is very, very low. Here, late in the pregnancy, we can see the basilar artery just in front of the midbrain. And you can see also inferior sagittal sinus extend by the vein of Galien, then the straight sinus, the beginning of the straight sinus. And as you can see, the pericallosal artery is fully empty with the signal. In transversal view, it's very easy to have the whole polygon of Willis and the mid cerebral arteries. In frontal view, we can see the tiny thalamic arteries coming from mid cerebral arteries, as you can see here. In abdominal view, we have a portal sinus. The hepatic blood circulation is richly represented with DFI. Here we have hepatic veins coming to vena cava inferior. Here we have umbilical vein, portal vessels, and hepatic veins. These vessels are visible in the same time on this section. Later in pregnancy, as you can see here, the umbilical vein and its collaterals are, as well as the portal sinus, are well defined. Here we have the portal network at the lower part of the liver. And you can see we have a good definition for the flow. Here we have a celiac trunk coming from aorta. And as you know, celiac trunk bifurcating into branches, on the left with splenic artery, on the right with common hepatic artery. We can also recognize inferior vena cava and portal vein. Here we have a superior mesenteric artery going toward to the small intestine. It's unusual to see so easily these little vessels. Here we have a distal superior mesenteric artery with distribution to intestinal loops. It's more accurate on this view at 32 weeks. Here we have a splenic artery. Splenic artery, as you know, runs behind the pancreas and the stomach to reach the spleen. And very late in the pregnancy, as you can see here at 40 weeks, we can recognize the spleen and its vascularization very easily showed. For the kidneys, we have interlobar arteries, and if we increase again, we can see interlobar arteries and cortical blood vessels. It would be useful when we have kidney disease. This is a special picture. When we make a section like that, we can see a small hypoechoic band just under the skin, as you can see with this line. And if with the DFI, you can see here, the small vessels, the subcutaneous vascularization highlighted by the DFI. Here is the transversal section. You can see the lower lip and the tongue, and you can see the vascularization through the lips and in the tongue. This is a thyroid at 32 weeks, and you can see carotid and jugular vein. And the vascularity of the thyroid is not visible when the thyroid is normal, but with DFI, its afferent vessels are visible, like you can see here. Another example, at the side, we can recognize the common femoral artery and the circumflex artery, as well as the perforating arteries in the muscles. This is very, very small arteries. To the leg, we have anterior and fibular arteries. We can follow these vessels very easily in the anterior approach. And with posterior approach, you can see we have very good resolution for these so small vessels. The level of acoustic energy is sent into the tissue by DFI is the same as the conventional Doppler. So as usual, during the first trimester, the setting must be adapted so that the acoustic power is as low as possible and the exposure time should be short. Here we have an embryo, 37 millimeter of length, and with the Doppler we can see easily the arterial flow and the venous flow coming back from the placenta, and you can see also the arteries in the brain. Even in difficult technical conditions, the sensibility is quite good. Here we have a large thickness of subcutaneous fat, and in this condition, we can see arteries, umbilical arteries passing through either side of the bladder. In the same condition, you can see the BMI is 35. We can see the carotids. And here we have a transversal view. We have arterial circle of Willis and the two mid-cerebral arteries. under normal conditions, the information is more accurate, like you can see here, anterior cerebral artery and its front branches. Here you have cerebral artery, but we have also this information, the superior sagittal sinus and the straight sinus. It's very, very tiny vessel and very, very low flow in these vessels, and we can see it. We can also easily identify as the place of cord insertion, and here we have cord insertion and maternal vessels at the basal plate. Finally, the placental vascularization is interesting. We know that the placenta is very vascularized, but it's difficult to highlight the vessels which irrigate it. Here you can see cotyledons. We have three cotyledons with the vessels, and here you can we can see villus trees, venous and arteries, and we have also chorionic vessels, and at the opposite side, the maternal vessels. By magnifying more, we can recognize the different layers, as here, the skin and subcutaneous fat, and abdominal wall muscle, and now uterine wall, myometrium, and just under, we have maternal blood vessel on the basal plate. You can imagine that the ability to more easily distinguish the border between placenta and myometrium could be a very useful in case of suspected placenta accreta. So, in conclusion, I would say that DFI method seems promising to improve the diagnostic analysis in many fields, and providing a more detailed evaluation in fine vascularization due to a good resolution and a high sensibility from this technology. I test this solution in Arrieta 855 and 755, and I was very, very satisfied. Thank you for your attention.
So, dear Dr. Althuser, I would like to thank you very much for your very nice presentation. You presented very nice cases with beautiful image. So I think that you gave a very good extent of the possibility of the new technologies for low velocity blood vessel detection. It seems to be a very promising technique. So after this session, we will have a Q&A session. So we will give the space to the audience for questions that will come right after this this speech. So I would like to thank you very much, Dr. Althuser. It was a real pleasure. Thanks a lot. Also to Frédéric Philippe to give the technical introduction. Thank you very much for joining, and hope to see you soon in the next webinar for ISUOG Congress. Thank you.